Hello everyone, welcome to my channel where I post a new video every week. This week I'll make the most demanding snack in my house, the cheeseburger bite. Yes, you heard it right. Cheeseburger in bite size that can fulfill your craving any time of the day. Usually at late nights when we feel like having something fried, these goodies come handy as they can be stored in freezer and you can just pop them in hot oil whenever you want. And the taste? Try for yourself this cheesy goodness. I bet no one can eat just one. If you're new to my channel, consider subscribing and press the bell icon for new videos. Let's get started. Add 2 tablespoons of butter in a hot pan on medium heat and let it melt. Saute 2 tablespoons of sliced onion until golden brown. Add 1.5 cup minced beef to the pan. You can use the meat of your choice. I have already washed and drained water from the meat. Add 1 teaspoon ginger paste and 1 teaspoon garlic paste. Mix in well. Now the meat will release a lot of water, so crank up the heat at this point to evaporate the excess water. Add 1/2 teaspoon cumin powder, 1/4 teaspoon turmeric powder to eliminate the sad color from the meat, 1/2 teaspoon chili powder, or you can use paprika if you want less heat, 1/2 teaspoon garam masala powder, or you can use curry powder too. Both of these spices can be found in any Bangladeshi, Indian or Pakistani grocery store. These spices will add a little bit of desi twist to the cheeseburger. And 1 teaspoon black pepper. Mix all the spices well into the meat. Notice that I haven't added any salt yet because it will release more water from the meat. Add 1 tablespoon chopped tomato and add a pinch of salt to help the tomato become mushy faster. As you can see, the water is gone. So turn the heat to medium again. At this point, add salt to taste. And I'll add another 1/2 teaspoon of pepper because I like spicy. But it is optional for you. Don't worry about adding all the hot spices because the sweetness of bread will balance it out. Keep stirring until the meat is fried well. You may be wondering why I named it cheeseburger bites. Well, every component of a cheeseburger is present in this recipe, excluding the lettuce and ignore the desi spices. Now, a burger is incomplete without condiments. You can add the condiment of your choice such as barbecue sauce, mustard, relish and so on to flavor the meat. I'll use the basics. Add 2 teaspoons of mayonnaise and 1 teaspoon of ketchup. This will really boost the taste. Combine with the meat well. This amount of filling can yield approximately 20 cheeseburger bites. We are almost done. add a little bit of green chili or jalapeno for garnishing and take it off the heat. Cut the cheese into small bite-sized pieces. Take the bread of your choice. Cut off the brown edges because it becomes harder when fried. I save the edges and use them in any other recipe. Take a bowl of normal water. And dip the bread for less than a second. Press with both hands to squeeze the water as best as you can. Let's see again. Press gently because you don't want to tear up the bread. Do for all the breads. Time for building up our burger. Take a spoonful of filling on the softened bread and place a piece of cheese on top. Gently fold the corners forming a round shape. Pinch the edges to seal it. You can try to build up in your hand. I find it convenient to shape the patty in my hand by cupping it so it gets the roundish shape easily. Seal the ends with your finger. If you have any question regarding this recipe or suggestion how we can improve the quality of our videos, feel free to let us know in the comment box below. Transfer in a plate and freeze for at least 30 minutes before frying. In a pan, heat oil and add the cheeseburger bites one by one and fry them in medium heat. Flip once golden on the other side. Flip again and fry until perfection. Drain any excess oil before transferring to a plate. The cheeseburger bites are ready. Serve them hot and enjoy this cheesy goodness. Deliciousness guaranteed. If you're enjoying our videos, please like and share with your close ones and subscribe to stay tuned for more videos. Also like and follow us on Facebook page linked in the description box because we post the written details there. See you next week. Stay safe.